Well, Italy has recorded the highest number of deaths in one day, a staggering 919 people. That takes the country's coronavirus death toll to more than 10,000 now. And if we don't flatten the curve, as medical experts continue warning us, Australia could be on the same trajectory. It's often said that we're only 2 weeks behind Italy in the progression of COVID-19, and nearly 1 month on, that nation remains in lockdown.
The pictures from Italy are just devastating. Exhausted medical teams, not enough ventilators for those who need them, and convoys of trucks taking coffins to cemeteries. So what is life like in an extended lockdown that's meant to stop all of that? And are there any lessons that we can learn here in Australia from the Italians about living in isolation?
Hermione Kitson is a former 7 News reporter who now lives in Pescara, Italy, right from the centre of the country. Hermione, good morning. It is great to talk to you. We're looking at the pictures from Italy, but it's a vastly different thing to actually be there living it. You've been in isolation for 3 weeks. What is it like to be there in Italy at the moment?
It's really difficult. There's really a sense of despair here because the numbers just keep on rising. You know, it has been 3 weeks. We've been really trying to be patient and hopeful and wait to see that peak and then hopefully the numbers stabilise. But that hasn't happened. And the mortality rate keeps on going up. Every day we keep seeing bad news. And it's really difficult because after 3 weeks, we just kind of don't see any end in sight. Mm. And it's difficult to keep morale up, that's for sure. I mean, I live in Pescara, in the centre of the country. So thankfully, we're not in the worst hit region of Lombardia in the north. You know, but the figures that you said in the introduction, more than 10,000 people who have died as a result of this outbreak here, you can imagine what kind of impact that has on the healthcare system here. It's really struggling. There are field hospitals being set up wherever possible. Patients are really kind of struggling now to get the care that they need.
Yeah, the pictures, the figures, it's just horrific. I mean, you're there, you've got two little kids, 18 months old and 3 years. Your husband's business has been shut down because of this. You know, what is it like being in isolation? How are you managing? Have you got cabin fever? How are the kids going?
It's difficult. It is difficult. We're by ourselves. We're not allowed to see anybody. We miss our friends. We miss our families. You know, we do our best on a daily basis to keep the kids occupied, to keep some kind of sense of normality. But of course, there's no school. You know, my three-year-old asks me, oh, what's going on? What does this coronavirus word mean? And, you know, there's, I guess, some kind of fine line between informing them and not scaring them about what the situation is at the moment. But, you know, we try our best in lockdown. We can only leave the house for urgent purposes, the supermarket or the pharmacy. And it's amazing after 3 weeks just how little you learn to live with. You know, I think that there's so much anxiety about going into lockdown. What do we need? And panic buying, and you need to have a certain amount of, you know, toilet paper or food and things like that in the cupboards. But really, you get by. And after 3 weeks, you know, you can still go to the supermarket here and find the things that you need to live off in terms of food and supplies. So, I mean, it's difficult, but people are trying their best to stay positive here, trying to stay positive.
A tough thing to do. Thank you so much, Hermione. Stay safe. We're really grateful into the insight into what it's like over there.
Yeah, Hermione, it's so lovely to see you. Thank you so much for talking to us.
It's amazing how casually we're talking about 919 people in a single day.
Yeah, I mean, that is just extraordinary.
It defies belief.